ऊर्जा मानव विकास की धुरी, आर्थिक विकास का आधार। ऊर्जा पेट्रोल और प्राकृतिक गैस प्रकृति प्रदत्त ऊर्जा के सबसे बड़े स्रोत, लेकिन दोनों ही सीमित मात्रा में उपलब्ध, दोनों ही तेजी से समाप्ति की कगार पर, दोनों में ही व्यर्थ जाने की असीमित संभावनाएं। 1970 में आए तेल के वैश्विक संकट ने जब देश के आयात बिलों को आसमान छूते देखा तो इनके संरक्षण का विचार सरकार के मन में आया और तब गठन हुआ पेट्रोलियम कंजर्वेशन एक्शन ग्रुप का, जो बाद में 1978 में पेट्रोलियम कंजर्वेशन रिसर्च एसोसिएशन में तब्दील हो गया। तब से आज तक पेट्रोलियम और प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय भारत सरकार का यह गैर लाभकारी संगठन ऊर्जा संरक्षण और ऊर्जा दक्षता को प्रोत्साहन देने के लिए कृत संकल्प है। अपने उद्देश्यों की पूर्ति के लिए पीसीआरए देश भर में प्रदर्शनियां, सम्मेलन, नुक्कड़ नाटक, कठपुतली शो और निबंध प्रतियोगिताएं आयोजित करने के साथ साथ विज्ञापनों द्वारा रेडियो और टीवी पर भी जन जागरण करता है। इसके अलावा सोशल साइट्स जैसे फेसबुक, ट्विटर, गूगल प्लस और यूट्यूब इत्यादि के माध्यम से भी लोगों को अपने साथ जोड़ता है पीसीआरए। अभियानों को कामयाब बनाने के लिए विभाग ने कई सेलिब्रिटीज जैसे मिस वर्ल्ड प्रियंका चोपड़ा।
आप भी अपने रसोई घर में खाना बनाते समय गैस या मिट्टी के तेल का इस्तेमाल सावधानी से करें, इसे व्यर्थ ना गवाएं, ये बहुत कीमती है।
और स्टार क्रिकेटर विराट कोहली जैसे प्रभावी व्यक्तित्वों का भी सहारा लिया।
देश के हित में आइए सब मिलकर ईंधन बचाएं, पैसा बचाएं।
ईंधन के सही इस्तेमाल के संदेश को पीसीआरए ने कई प्रभावशाली कमर्शियल एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स के जरिए जनता तक पहुंचाया है। पीसीआरए ऊर्जा संरक्षण को लेकर नए नए प्रयोग भी करता रहा है। पीसीआरए ने दिल्ली के चौराहों पर लगी रेड लाइट्स पर टाइमर लगाए और अब एक और नई पहल है जिसका नाम है स्टार लेबलिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर पेट्रोलियम बेस्ड इक्विपमेंट। ब्यूरो ऑफ एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी के साथ मिलकर पीसीआरए ने डोमेस्टिक एलपीजी स्टोव्स, डीजल जनरेटर्स और मोनोसेट पंप्स पर स्टार लेबलिंग शुरू की, जिसने ऊर्जा संरक्षण का एक और नया रास्ता खोला। ईंधन की बचत के अभियानों को गति देने के लिए पीसीआरए अनेक मंचों का इस्तेमाल करता है। वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे, वर्ल्ड एनर्जी डे, अनेक त्योहारों और रथ यात्राओं में भी पीसीआरए एनर्जी सेविंग का संदेश देता है। ऐसा ही एक प्रतिष्ठित समारोह है ऑयल एंड गैस कंजर्वेशन फोर्टनाइट, यानी तेल और प्राकृतिक गैस संरक्षण पखवाड़ा, जो कि पेट्रोलियम और प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय भारत सरकार द्वारा प्रतिवर्ष आयोजित किया जाता है। तेल संरक्षण सप्ताह के तौर पर 1991 में शुरू हुई इस राष्ट्रव्यापी मुहिम की सफलता को देखते हुए 1997 में इसे सप्ताह के स्थान पर पखवाड़े के रूप में मनाया जाने लगा। गैसों की ईंधन के रूप में बढ़ती उपयोगिता के कारण 2004 में इसे OGCF यानी तेल और गैस संरक्षण पखवाड़े का नाम दे दिया गया। इस अवसर पर संरक्षण के क्षेत्र में काम करने वाले लोगों और संगठनों को सम्मानित किया जाता है। अनेक सांस्कृतिक और शैक्षणिक कार्यक्रमों का आयोजन होता है, कई तरह की वर्कशॉप्स लगाई जाती हैं, आने वाली पीढ़ी को संरक्षण की दिशा में तैयार करने के लिए निबंध और पेंटिंग प्रतियोगिताओं का भी आयोजन किया जाता है।
नमस्कार, फ्यूल सेविंग लीग 2015 के नेशनल फाइनल्स में आप सबका स्वागत है। द पेट्रोलियम कंजर्वेशन रिसर्च एसोसिएशन Under the guidance of the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, organizes the Oil and Gas Conservation Fortnight every year in the second half of January. Is fortnight ka aim jo hai bada simple hota hai, to increase awareness about conservation of natural resources, of petroleum, of natural gas. The motto of this campaign is very simple: Indhan bachao, jandhan badao. We're trying to save and increase the wealth not just of individuals but also of the nation. Saving of natural resources is important not just for the economy but also very important for our planet. Hamara jo future hai, hamare jo bacche hai, inke liye hum ek acha prosperous planet chhod ke jaye, plush with natural resources, that's what's very important. And we can do that only by ways of conservation and efficiency in usage of natural resources. To spread the word, हमने एक पैन इंडिया क्विज किया स्कूल स्टूडेंट्स के लिए। क्लास 7 से लेके क्लास 9 तक के स्कूल स्टूडेंट्स इसमें भाग ले सकते थे। इसका नाम था फ्यूल सेविंग लीग 2015। 22 स्टेट्स में 35 सिटीज में ये क्विज स्कूल्स में खेला गया. Over 5 lakh students took part in this quiz. They became zonal champions, and from zonal champions today, they've come to take part in the national final. Each zone has sent one team of 2 students. So today we have the cream of the crop. 10 students representing 5 schools out of 5 lakh that took part. तो आइए इन 5 टीमों के साथ, इन zonal champions के साथ खेलते हैं Fuel Saving League 2015 का national final. आइए मिलते हैं अपने पांचों फाइनलिस्ट से. ईस्टर्न एनर्जाइजर्स, प्लीज वेलकम विद्यांशु शेखर एंड आदित्या कुमार. नेक्स्ट टीम इज द वेस्टर्न विजिलेंस, ऋषिकेश कलघटकर एंड सुमुख पिंगे. लेट्स वेलकम आवर नेक्स्ट टीम नाउ ऑन स्टेज, द नॉर्दर्न नर्चरर्स. प्लीज वेलकम जयवर्धन सिंह एंड अपूर्व झा. Let's welcome our next school now, coming to represent the South Zone, the Southern Savers, Rudra Teja and Abhinav Hampifoli. And now let's welcome our fifth and final team here for the national finals of the Fuel Saving League, the Central Conservers, Digvijay Singh and Rahul Joshi. This is going to be a very serious and very competitive quiz. We have 6 rounds. Okay, let's start with round 1. This round is 5 text-based questions. It's direct, that's going to go starting from the first team on my right, and then we're going to go this way, which is going to be clockwise for the first round. There's 10 points for a correct answer. There's no negative marking. There's no passing in this round. So direct question just for you. 10 points if you get it right. Nothing to lose if you get it wrong. 30 seconds to answer the question. So we're going to start with you, DPS Ranchi. This field includes planning and operation of energy-related production and consumption units. Objectives are resource conservation, climate protection, and cost savings, while the users have permanent access to the energy they need. It is connected closely to environmental management. Which subject are we talking about?
Fuel conservation.
Fuel conservation is your answer. Not a good start for you, DPS Ranchi. That is the wrong answer. The answer I was looking for was energy management. That was the answer I was looking for. Unfortunately, not a good start for you. But don't worry, this is just the beginning. There's a long road ahead. We're going to move on now to our second team from Panjim. This is your question. This one is for 10 points. An electric motor transforms most of its energy into useful kinetic energy and wastes only a small amount as thermal energy. Which property of the electric motor am I describing?
First law of thermodynamics.
No, that is not the answer I was looking for. Efficiency, which can be defined as the amount of energy extracted from a system divided by the total energy you put into the system. So, not a very good start for our first two teams. I'm going to move to my left now. DPS Noida, this is your direct question. It is also worth 10 points. Here it is. After the oil spill in 2010 in the Gulf of Mexico, ecologists released thousands of Alcanivorax borcumensis into the sea to help clear up the remaining oil. What am I talking about?
Sponges.
Sponges is your answer. DPS Noida, not a good start for you as well. The answer I was looking for is microbes or bacteria. Well, Presidency School Bengaluru, it's up to you now. Let's see if you can break the jinx of our opening round here in the national finals. Here is your question. All I can tell you about it is, this one's not easy either, but here it goes. Energy content and combustion quality are key fuel performance properties. Other significant performance properties of this fuel are stability, lubricity, fluidity, volatility, non-corrosivity and cleanliness. The most common types of such fuel is Jet A1, and it also has other types as JP1, JP4, JP5 and JPTS. What are we talking about?
It's jet fuel. It's fuel that aircrafts use to fly.
Well, jet fuel or aviation fuels, that is the correct answer. Well done, 10 points. Opening the scoring here in the national finals of the Fuel Saving League. Good start, Bengaluru. Moving on now to Oxford Public School, Gwalior, from our central zone. Here is your question. It's also worth 10 points. Project Sunshine of the US seeds giant Monsanto seeks to bring about a yellow revolution in tribal areas of India and is being implemented under various names in Gujarat, Orissa and Rajasthan, among others. For which crop is Project Sunshine being implemented?
It's wheat.
Wheat. Your answer is wheat. It's not the answer I was looking for. Unfortunately, no points for you. Maize with the right answer. It is maize. Well, that was the first round. We played it very simple, very direct. From the second round onwards now, this is where the fun starts, because this is where the buzzer comes into play. Well, these are multiple choice questions. I will ask the question. You will press the buzzer. There will be four choices along with the question. Give us the correct answer, get 10 points. If you press the buzzer and give me the wrong answer, you get minus 5. So teams, be very careful. I will give a maximum of 5 seconds for you to answer the question. Are you guys ready? Now here's the first question. The lowest average generating cost, we have Bengaluru on the buzzer. What's the answer? You're saying it's solar photovoltaic. Unfortunately, that's the wrong answer, Bengaluru. Minus 5 for you. The answer, of course, that we were looking for is hydroelectric facilities. The lowest average generating cost per kilowatt hour comes from which of the following energy sources? Not a good start for any of the teams, but we still have more questions on the buzzer. Here is your second question. LPG is predominantly the mixture of propane and...
butane.
Panjim says butane. Let's see if that's the correct answer. It is the correct answer. Congratulations. Well done. 10 points. Moving on now to question 3. Which of the following forms of energy have a low long term, by which we mean next 50 years, estimated availability? Buzzer goes Bengaluru.
Coal, a coal.
You say a coal. Bomb explodes, which means that's not the right answer. The answer we were looking for is petroleum. And move on to our next question. According to the Kyoto Protocol, CDM stands for... Wally, after a lot of thought, goes on the buzzer. What's the answer?
Carbon depletion mechanism.
Carbon depletion mechanism. Let's have a look if that's the right answer or not. It's not, unfortunately. The answer we were looking for is clean development mechanism. Clean development mechanism is the correct answer. So minus 5 for you there as well, Gwalior. The next question. Which is the safest and most environment-friendly mode of transportation of petroleum? The choices are... Noida, not needing the choices. What's your answer?
Pipeline.
Pipeline is your answer. Is that the correct answer? 10 points! DPS Noida! Moving on to our next question. Presenting the load demand of a consumer against time of the day is known as... The choices are... On the buzzer, Bengaluru.
Demand curve.
Demand curve is your answer. And demand curve is the wrong answer. Minus 5 for Bengaluru. The right answer we were looking for is the load curve. Our next question. The full form of ESCO or ESCO is... goes on the buzzer again after much thought. What's your answer?
The answer is C. Energy Service Corporation.
Energy Service Company. Energy Service Co. Energy Service Company is your answer. It's the correct answer. Oxford Public School, Gwalior. Good answer. 10 points. The 8th question out of 10 in this round. The least efficient energy conversion device listed amongst these four is which one? Here are your choices. We have Bengaluru on the buzzer now.
Steam turbine.
You say the steam turbine, the least efficient energy conversion. No, in fact, it has a very good conversion rate. C is the correct answer. Due to their relative inefficiency and...